If you killed a bunch of seals in an oil leak, or dislocated a tribe in Mozambique, it's a UN violation every time you speak. Chances are you're the douche of the week.
This week, the first douche cat to be let out of the douche bag is Love. Sure, it might just be a four-letter word, all we need and many a splendid thing, but turns out it's also destroying a great many other splendid things. This bridge, for example.
On Sunday, nearly 2.5 metres of railings collapsed under the weight of those so-called locks of love.
Yes, the age-old tourist tradition of padlocking your initials to monuments and throwing away the key has brought down a 200-year-old bridge in Paris. It was estimated that the bridge had 93 metric tons worth of locks clinging to its railings, and in the end, just couldn't stand the weight of metal and tacky sentiment.
If we were going to lock our love in, this was the place to do it. Because we've loved each other for such a long time, we might as well continue the tradition.
And why not? What could be more romantic than a trip to Bunnings to pick up the international symbol for Please Don't Break Into My House? Of course, this isn't the first time the love locks have caused a friend to wake up on the wrong side of the French word for bed. Early this year, a No Love Locks campaign was launched, arguing the keepsakes were causing rust to enter the waterways. Also, falling locks have the potential to hit and kill boaters passing by on the River Seine.
So what do you have to say for yourself, lovers? After polluting lakes, destroying landmarks and threatening lives, I think a sorry might be in order.
Love means never having to say you're sorry.
Next up, it's Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe. Early this year, the International Court of Justice ordered an end to Japan's commercial hunting of whales in the Southern Ocean. But this week, the PM said he wants to do the same thing to whaling that Justin Timberlake did to sexy. I'm bringing sexy back. Now let's be clear, even after the ICJ ruling in March, it's still not illegal for Japan to hunt whales, so long as they're doing it for scientific purposes. Like scientifically measuring how painful their deaths can be while cutting them up for a food that statistically no one likes to eat.
Head up.
Staying true to form, Shinzo has argued that eating whale meat is a long-held tradition in Japan. Of course, so was ceremonial disembowelment, and he's yet to urge the Japanese population to plunge a sword into their midsection. And finally, rounding out this week's directory of douchery, it's you. Yes, you, me, and everyone else that doesn't fit the first two categories. Humanity has made the douche list for this.
The oceans of the world are polluted with all kinds of human waste, but now scientists have identified a new kind of rock forming on the shores of Hawaii that is made of plastic.
This is plastiglomerate, and it's what you should expect when you spend 60 years producing a thing that won't break down. No, not even by you, classic R&B trio Vertical Hold.
The billions of tons of plastic pollution we produce every year is now merging with other geological materials to create an entirely new type of stone, which could potentially last millions of years.
So, when humanity has gone the way of Vertical Hold and disappeared from the face of the earth, future advanced civilizations can dig down and find the exact geological point when we stopped giving a toss about our environment.